Indian Air Force para-commandos have been airlifted from Udhampur and brought to Jammu this morning. Another aircraft is airborne to pick up para-commandos from Sarsawa. That's the latest information that's coming in. So the IAF has been pressed into action. Shudhi, can you give us any more updates on the same and the role that the para-commandos would play?
Well, I mean, you know, in these kind of operations, there's a special forces that are moved in. There is a special forces regiment that is positioned out here. And some time ago, they were asked to go in because the special forces are much more, you know, equipped and trained to handle situations like that. It's not that the infantry, so to say, is not equipped. They are also equipped, but the special forces, being the special forces, are always inducted into in these kind of situations. It's nothing new. It's nothing out of the routine or out of the books. This is what normal procedure is. The four para commando regiment is located there, and they have been asked to move in to also go into the attack and try and neutralize the terrorists, in as quickly as possible. That said, the army will take as long as it wants. There is no, I mean, the normal or the instructions that go down is, do not hurry into any kind of an operation.
Right.
Do not try to take any collateral damages. Do not try to take any casualties. Take your time, get out everybody, and then go in for the kill.
Right. Shudhi, stay on with us. Shivarur also joins us on the phone line right now. Shiv, what will be the operating procedure, the modus operandi of our security forces? Because what we're being given to understand is that the terrorists are firing only just one stray bullet here and there. They're trying to engage us in a longer battle.
That is correct, Polami. Now, I don't think we're going to go into the specifics of precisely what kind of operation this is going to be. But, like Shudhi just mentioned, the special forces have basically entered the operational theater of where this attack has just taken place. It's inside a cantonment, so it's a built-up area that brings with it its own complexities and challenges. The special forces, as Shudhi also mentioned, are brought in, when there's a situation of this kind, because they're specially trained, for operations in difficult circumstances where you've got armed terrorists who are, cornered in a built-up area, even though that particular place has been isolated. Now, the commandos who've been deployed here are some of the Indian Army's best commandos. Some of these commandos have also been involved, in cross-border raids and surgical strikes in the past. The country should have absolutely no doubt that the very finest soldiers have been deployed in this counter-strike operation against these terrorists who've infiltrated in the Sunjuwan cantonment. Now, how this actually pans out is going to be interesting to see, because it's still a very precarious operation. You've got 3 to 4 terrorists apparently holed up in an area. They are cornered out, but they are armed. It is not known how much ammunition they have and what kind of endurance they are capable of at this time, Polami. But all of that will be taken into account. You will have these commandos get briefed by the infantry unit on the ground in that particular area and get a sense of the lay of the land before they plan their next strike.
Right. Shiv, thank you so much for those inputs. We'll go across to Ashwini Kumar, who's joining us live from outside the Sunjuwan Army Camp in Jammu. Ashwini, do we have an idea of how much ammunition and reinforcements have these terrorists come in with?
As per my previous experience, that terrorist has a grenade, rocket launchers, they have a AK-47 rifles, pistols, and they have some this dry fruit also with them. But that has to be seen after the killing of these terrorists. Normally, these fedayeen people, they came with their long shoes also. It has to be seen whether these are the fresh infiltration bid last night, or they have come from the other side also, maybe from the Punjab side also, or from Punch Rajouri side, or the Kashmir side also. That has to be seen by the investigation agency after the neutralization of these terrorists. But they have taken the position, and this is a big area. Sunjuwan camp is a big area, and the brigade headquarters is there, the family quarters are there. There is a stadium also there, but all the people, they have been told not to move out of the houses because of the terrorists can attack them, and they have been a pinpointed place, but one of the terrorists has entered the ensuing quarter where he is firing, but intermediate firing is coming from the terrorist side, not more fire, because they don't want to use the maximum ammunition. They want to keep their ammunition with them, but the attacking party is going near to the terrorist side and they want to utilize them as early as possible. But the army officer, they have given the instruction to the field commanders that at least there should not be a casualty from outside. It should be avoided, because in 2003 the same army camp was attacked from the Bathindi area, where this area, though the area is other part, but it's a big area, and the terrorists has been covered up, and they will be neutralized very soon. But it will take, but the army is taking precaution not to
absolutely
lose
the army has to be cautious know. Because there are civilians who are entrapped inside that seven, army camp. Ashwini, stay on with us. I'll go across to my colleague Shuja ul Haq. Shuja, you're getting some new information that's coming in from the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly. Brief us.
Pulumi, I can barely hear you, but let me tell you that there has been an update just now. I'm just hearing from sources that inside the assembly, one of the government ministers has informed that two JCOs have been killed in this attack, and the others are still injured. There is also a huge ruckus inside the assembly. We're also told that the government has disapproved and disassociated itself from the speaker's comment on possible hand of Rohingyas in this attack. Snowballing into a political controversy as well inside the J&K assembly. As far as on the ground situation is concerned, sources in the army suggest that para-commandos have been dispatched to the area. We're not giving out details as far as the operations are concerned, because that's something we do not do. But what is very clear from the facts is that special forces have reached the camp. They are engaging these militants. So far, the officials are saying that immediately after entering into the compound, these four attackers split into two groups. This is a very usual modus operandi that these attackers employ, and the basic motive of doing it is to engage the security forces at various fronts, in a sense increase the operational area. And that by doing that, they also ensure that the operation carries on for a longer period of time. How is it that the security forces will now engage them is something that we'll have to wait and watch for. But the biggest challenge that would remain is to ensure that the casualties are limited, because there are civilians also inside the camp, particularly the families of soldiers.
Absolutely.
Follow me?
Of course, we'll stay mindful of the fact that we do not give out any sort of operational details as we cover this live terror operation, which is this anti-terror operation, which is currently underway inside the Sunjuwan Army Camp in Jammu. Going across to my colleague, Editor Defense, Shudhi Ranjan Sen. Shudhi, you've been speaking to your sources within the army. What are they telling you in terms of how well equipped have these terrorists come?
Well, I mean, from the initial reports that we are getting, they're very, very heavily armed. That's what I've been told. And interestingly, what we are seeing is the kind of engagement that is there. And as Ashwini, Shuja and all my other colleagues from the ground are reporting, it seems that the terrorists are, saving up their ammunition, which means they're trying to kind of lengthen the engagement. They are in no hurry at all, which also gives an indication of the level of training that they would have got, because only very, very trained soldiers in these will tell you that when you are in a situation like this, when you're against the enemy, you do not waste ammunition. You use your ammunition as little as possible, and you keep engaging the entire engagement, and in that perhaps try to escape and or try to inflict casualties. And this is exactly what from the ground the reports are coming. So an indication, a very keen indication, so to say, of the kind of training that they would have had. Follow me.
Right. Right, Shruti, and earlier you were mentioning about the fact that, you know, it possibly is a little easy to infiltrate in from the Sambar Katua sector because there's not much fencing that you can do because of rivers and rivulets. Then what do you do in terms of preventing such an attack?
Well, it's very, very difficult. I mean, and that's exactly why, you know, this area, specifically this area, although there is no dispute with Pakistan on where exactly the border lies, and it's called the international border, although Pakistan wants to call it the working border or something, or some sort, nomenclature they give. But this is a border that is decided. And the terrain of the border specifically in the Katua and the Sambar sector, like we see in the LC in the areas of Gurez, are very, very difficult to man. And a fence in some areas just cannot be put up, because every time you put up a fence, when the seasonal rivers come into flow, they get washed away. So apart from, you know, putting boots on the ground, it's very little that you can do. Of course, after the Pathankot attack, we have seen that we are trying. The BSF is trying to bring in more sensors into these areas. There is a pilot project that's on. In some parts of the border, they have tried to put in sensors. But given the kind of vegetation, given the kind of growth that is there, trees, elephant grass,
right,
and the rivulets, it's very difficult.
Absolutely. Should we stay on with us? Because then I'll take that question with our defense expert, AGB Jaini, now joining us on the phone line. Mr. Jaini, how do you prevent such an attack? Because as our editor defense, Shruti Ranjan Sen, was pointing out, this is an area which you cannot fence in a way. Because of the Sambar Katua sector is such, only boots can be put on the ground. Then what do you do to prevent such an attack?
Let me be very, very emphatic that there is very little that you can do to defend against a fidaine attack. A fidaine attack, a suicide bomber attack, these people who have entered this cantonment are prepared to die. They are fidaine, they are highly motivated, they are very strongly trained, they are absolutely hardcore. It is very little that you can do to defend against them. So, I heard you asking somebody about the terrain. The terrain is called broken terrain. There's a riverine, there are rocks, there are jungles. It's very, very difficult. You cannot seal the border, you cannot make the border airtight. Therefore, these things, whether there was any security lapse and how they entered and all, that's not the issue today. That will be discussed tomorrow after we examine the whole thing. But the fact now is that this is nothing unusual. Pakistan has done this in Sambar, Kathua, in Jammu, in Pathankot, on the international border, not on the line of control, but across the international border. So they are following a very sustained strategy of beating India by 1,000 cuts. This is one of those 1,000 cuts that has taken place at 4 a.m. this morning. So unless we make Pakistan pay the price, pay the cost of such nefarious activities, and unless we make Pakistan realize the consequences of such absolute vulgar activities against India, I'm afraid this sort of thing has been going on since 1947, it is going on today, and it will go on tomorrow. We must stop jumlabaji and we must make Pakistan pay the consequences of such nefarious activities.
Absolutely. Major General AGB. AJB Jaini, thank you so much for those inputs and that perspective. We'll, of course, come back to that story. I'd request all our reporters to stay on with us. We'll just come back after this very short break.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share, and subscribe to India Today. Also, check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.